Makofi! Makofi!
It is my pleasure and honor to present the ISO 9001 certificate to Bungoma West Hospital.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
celebrate their decision to begin and to give this family, this community, such a wonderful facility that can handle the life of many from far and near. We want to thank you. And as religious people, it is important to celebrate one another. The achievement of one another is an achievement of all of us. I'm asking you to join us in this happy mood as we celebrate our hospital and as we appreciate the recognition that the service that are being offered in this facility is worthy, recognized from within and afar. I welcome our brother priests to join us in this Eucharistic celebration. Our Father Dean, Father Protas Oshanju, who is the parish priest of Jebutais, and he coordinates the priests within this deanery. We want to welcome you, and he's the one who is going to lead us through this Eucharistic celebration. Father Protas, you are most welcome to share with us the joy we have for our brother, for our sister, and for this healthy facility. I want also to welcome in our midst our brother and our collaborator, Father Pius Lukhale, who is in our midst. We thank you, Father, your coming is a blessing to us. We want also to recognize the presence of our brother and priest, Father Vincent, who is serving at our mother church, Kibabi. Father Phil, welcome. We are proud of you. And in our midst, I know we have so many stakeholders. I've seen our bankers. I've seen so many. And I recognize all of you in our midst. On behalf of Christ the King Cathedral, under my leadership, I want to welcome you to this celebration. This celebration is not just a celebration, but it is a blessing to all of us. And when we get out of this place, let us be evangelists. Let us take the good gospel to the world that we have a facility that is really giving good service to our people. Receive the greeting from the two bishops, our bishop, Bishop Mark Kadima, who is supposed to be with us, but because of national responsibility, he has gone to attend to it in Nairobi. Receive also the greeting from the Bishop of Kakamega, Joseph Obanyi, who is supposed to be with us, but because of national duties, he has gone there. My brother Amos, we serve with him here, and therefore, my brother Amos, I'm happy, I'm proud to be with him. By the way, it is a blessing Cathedral Parish has two prophets. Prophet Jeremiah, who is speaking, and Prophet Amos. And that is really a blessing. Prophet Jared, be assured of the prayer of the two prophets. Father Protas, lead us in your Eucharistic celebration.
Neema ya Bwana wetu Yesu Kristu na upendo wa Mungu Baba na ushirika wa Roho Mtakatifu viwe nanyi nyote.
Na viwe rohoni mwako.
Ndugu zangu, tukiri dhambi zetu ili tupate kustahilishwa kuadhimisha mafumbo matakatifu. Namuungamia Mungu Mwenyezi.
Nani ndugu zangu, kwani nimekosa mno kwa mawazo, kwa maneno, kwa matendo na kwa kutotimiza wajibu. Nimekosa sana. Ndiyo maana na kuomba Maria mwenye heri, Bikira daima, malaika na watakatifu wote, nanyi ndugu zangu, niombeeni kwa Bwana Mungu wetu.
Mungu Mwenyezi atuhurumie, atusamehe dhambi zetu na atufikishe kwenye uzima wa milele.
Amina.
Kushirikiana kwa karibu zaidi kwa njia ya Bwana wetu Yesu Kristo mwanao anayeishi na kutawala nawe katika umoja wa Roho Mtakatifu Mungu daima na milele.
Amina.
Bwana aliniokoa katika hofu zangu zote.
haitalishinda. Aleluya, aleluya.
Atakapokuja mwana wa mtu katika utukufu wake na malaika wote pamoja naye, ataketi katika kiti cha utukufu wake, na mataifa yote yatakusanywa mbele yake. Atawabagua watu kama vile mchungaji anavyobagua kondoo na mbuzi. Atawaweka kondoo upande wake wa kulia na mbuzi upande wake wa kushoto. Halafu mfalme atawaambia wale wa kulia kwake, njoni ninyi mliobarikiwa na Baba yangu, urithini ufalme uliowekewa tangu mwanzo wa dunia. Kwa maana nalikuwa na njaa mkanilisha, nalikuwa na kiu mkaninywesha, nalikuwa mgeni mkanikaribisha, nalikuwa uchi mkanivisha, nalikuwa mgonjwa mkaja kunitazama, nalikuwa kifungoni mkaja kuniona. Hapo waadilifu watamjibu na kusema, Bwana, lini tulipokuona na njaa tukakulisha au una kiu tukakunywesha? Lini tulikuona u mgeni tukakukaribisha au kifungoni tukaja kukuona? Mfalme atawajibu, amin nawaambieni, mliomtendea mmoja wapo wa hawa ndugu zangu walio wadogo, mlinitendea mimi. Kisha atawaambia na wale wa kushoto, ondokeni kwangu ninyi walaaniwa, nendeni katika moto wa milele uliowekewa tayari kwa shetani na malaika wake. Kwa maana nalikuwa na njaa hamkunilisha, nalikuwa na kiu hamkuninywesha, nalikuwa mgeni hamkunikaribisha, nalikuwa uchi hamkunivisha, nalikuwa mgonjwa na kifungoni hamkunitazama. Hapo wao pia watajibu na kusema, Bwana, lini tulikuona una njaa au kiu au mgeni au huna nguo au umgonjwa au kifungoni tusikutumikie? Naye atawajibu, amin nawaambieni, mliokosa kumtendea mmojawapo katika hawa wadogo, hamkunitendea mimi. Na hao wataingia katika adhabu ya milele, bali waadilifu wataingia katika uzima wa milele. Injili ya Bwana.
Sifa kwako, ee Kristo.
Hasa ndio alikuwa nilipokuwa magonjwa anakileta. So habari yenu magonjwa. Mimi ndio wagonjwa mmekuja. Meet your neighbor. Just shake your hand with your neighbor. Tell him welcome. Asanteni sana. I once went to a celebration which was very brief. Sherehe kama hii. Baada ya mafuriko kule Budalangi mwaka wa 1998, I worked there. And the doctors and nurses were doing a lot. And the patients, some could die in our presence in the church. Because mafuriko yalikuwa kila mahali. Na magonjwa aina mbalimbali. But then we had a thanksgiving. And there was a doctor who did so much. Na watu walitaka kumshukuru after yale mafuriko. El Nino, you remember. In that ceremony that I was presiding over, when it came to speeches, everybody was praising the doctor. Kwa kujitolea, kwa kufanya kazi. Wakati wake ulipowadia wa kuzungumza na watu, the doctor rose and said, niko na mgeni wa heshima hapa. Na yeye ndiye hotuba yangu. Na watu wote walikuwa wanaangalia wageni wanaalikwa, wamekuja kwa magari makubwa nini na nini. Lakini huyo mgeni wa heshima alikuwa mama ya daktari, the mother. Na akamleta mbele na akasema, huyu ndiye mgeni wangu wa heshima. Huyu ndiye amenifanya jinsi nili. End of the speech. And we went to meet. Was that not marvelous? We have come here to give thanks. To give thanks to the work of our hands. To give thanks to our brothers and sisters for the services they render to the community. And here they are. Here we are. We must thank our parents. Hao ndio watu wa kwanza. Unajua mmepatia sifa nyingi kwa daktari huyu. Lakini mimi nasema sifa siendee kwa wazazi wao. Waliomlea, waliomwelimisha, na akawa jinsi alivyo, akawa na marafiki kama sisi hapa. Na akaanza kutoa huduma kwa wengine. So today, I'll briefly say something on the service that Jesus is inviting us to render to our brothers and sisters in the community. Katika Injili ya Mathayo, 25, mstari wa 31, hadi 46. Mathayo analeta ombi katika injili hii la wazi kabisa iwepo jumuiya yenye bidii na yenye kujali katika hotuba Yesu aliyoitoa kwa wafuasi wake mlimani kisoma Mathayo 5 mstari wa 20. Heri walio maskini, heri wenye njaa, heri na kadhalika zote. Hapa Yesu anawaita waadilifu, wale walio mtambua yeye katika wenye njaa, wenye kiu, wageni, walio uchi, wafungwa, na mwisho wagonjwa. Hawa ndio ndugu zake wadogo kabisa anaojitambulisha nao. These groups are the ones that Jesus is identifying himself. So tunaposhukuru, tukumbuke vikundi hivi. How do we render ourselves to them? Mimi kwanza nashukuru Mungu kwa sababu nimezaliwa hapa hapa na najua jinsi Kanduyi imekuwa. Kianza kujua Kanduyi ilikuwa tu na duka moja, small shop. Hapa ilikuwa inaitwa center. No trailer stopped here. Not. Kini hiyo duka ilikuwa hapo karibu na supermarket ya mzee Masiro. Wale wazee wenye wako hapo mnakumbuka Masiro chini hapo. The next thing you saw as you head to town was the carton bin. Wateo tulu. The carton. Then the next thing you saw, airship. There was the weather, meteorological. I don't know who destroyed it. No wonder why we don't have good rains. We had a very beautiful meteorological station. Then you get to the hospital. And I tell you, it was a hospital during the colonial days and during the post-independence. A hospital where you arrived and the nurse received you. And the injections were being boiled on the stove. You can know what we underwent. When the doctor said, the nurse came and read your name and said, next. And the injections from the sufuria being boiled. The services were there. And then the cereal boats, the railway, very beautiful. The railway station, then the post office. And from there you went to Matata shop, where we used to kupima mashati peke yake, hakuna suruali ya Christmas. Then you went to Costa Hotel ya Mama Alice. Then you went hotel ya soko hapo Omari, ijai nifupi ni endile mpinika ni manda asimbo. Then you are in the market, and that is the end of the town. But now when we look around and we say, the population that has come here, we give thanks to God. Tushukuru Mungu. Kwamba mambo yamebadilika. Watu wamezaliwa. Watu wameenda shule. Watu wamesoma. And what can you return to the community? Ukienda shule, ujisomei. Let us remember that. Whether you have a PhD it is for others. A doctor, it is for others. You come back and we see it. Katika huduma hizi ambazo Yesu amesitaja katika injili ya leo. Wenye njaa, wenye kiu, walio uchi, wagonjwa, hawa ndiyo tunaalikwa kuwahudumia. Hii ndiyo hukumu ya mwisho yenye Mungu atatuuliza. So we learn to come and give services to our community, to our fellow brothers and sisters. Na hapa ndipo tunaona na tunapata baraka ya Mwenyezi Mungu. Ndipo nimesema mimi nikiwa hapa na shukuru kwa sababu nimeona hii. I said no trailer or vehicle could stop here because there was nothing to stop. Slowly some things started coming. Na mmeziona, and you can agree with me here that in Kandui we have more bars than hospitals. Ukweli ama oro? We have more bars than schools. Yeah, about your life in the end. So, that's a mnajali tu wenye kiu. Nikuwa na kiu ukaninyoesha. Sindiyo kwa jini tunakenda. Kwenye wanaenda hapo. Kwenye wanafuekwa kwa drip. Kila siku nikipita hapo watu wako kwa drip. Yani drips. Na kuna wateja wa kila siku. Kini wakimwambia enda hapo waste wa kuweka kwa drip wataki. Lakini ile ya huko anajipeleka mwenye.
Mwenye.
So why do we do that? So that's why I'm thanking God. But at least on the highway here, a big hospital has come. Somebody tried on this Gorofa here, Watira. Amejari. Na wenye imani hapo wameende wamepona. Chenye kina kuponya ni imani. Sindio? Amejaribu miaka hiyo yote. Kitoka tu kwa nyumbani mtu anasema njawati. Hata wa haru mwajamu district ya heja sawati. Na ama yao. No physiotherapy, no sijui what. All those are not there, but ya napona. Sindio? Nini naponyesha mtu? Imani. Mnatibu tu lakini imani ndiyo ina? Mponya. So he tried. Slowly we have seen this come up, another one has come up there. But people are putting energy in the things that pass. But you look at the health section. It is with us. As long as people are being born on daily basis, we need health services. Bars can be closed. But our hospital. When you come to Florida, upon their club, those days, Busa. Mchiso, Simoya alifunga. Every market was very active because of those clubs. But when they were declared null, the markets collapsed. But hospitals, Hii ni kazi ya Kristo. Kazi ambayo Yesu alikuja kwamba wagonjwa wapate kupona. Vipofu, viwete na kadhalika. So we discharge our services to our brothers and sisters. And we do that with love. Ukifanya hii kazi kama wewe una upendo, wewe ni kitu bure. Atufanye hii kazi. It is a calling. And we do it with love. That's why I was saying when you arrived in those days in the district hospital, you are received. Nurses or sisters, we call that Teresa. Very well. Now ulianza tu kupona on the reception. But these days, when we never end the letter stranger, weka mgonjwa yako hapo, sukuma. That is, we must change our attitude on how to receive the patients and on how to work with the patients. Najua leo nimefurahi sana, nimetembezwa hospitali yote, kila mtu anang'ara. Muendelee hivyo every day, not only today. That is the way to go. Let us be receptive. That is where the attitude of the patient, even before you administer those drugs or whatever, the patient is already in the same hands. So it is teamwork. Daktari hawezi kufanya hiyo kazi peke yake. Kuanzia tu kwa security officer mpaka. Iwe mpaka kwa maternity or wapi. Please, kindly, I use all those words. Let us serve with love. With love. Secondly, let us keep in mind that we are handling God's people. Yeyote anapokuja, yeyote anayeletwa hapo katika hali yoyote, let us see the image of God and the likeness. As we serve. And God will bless you through your services. Kwa hii kazi ambayo anakuambia nalikuwa kifungoni mkaja kuniona. Alikuwa na kiu mkaninywesha. Nalikuwa mgeni mkanikaribisha. Nalikuwa mgonjwa mkaja kunitazama. Nalikuwa kifungoni mkaja kuniona. Hapo waadilifu watamjibu na kusema, Bwana, ni lini tulipokuona? Au ni lini tulikuona mgonjwa ukifungoni na hivi? Naye atawajibu, amini nawaambieni, mlio kosa kumtendea mmoja wapo katika hawa wadogo, hamukunitendea mimi. Na hawa wataingia katika adhabu ya milele. Wale waadilifu wataingia katika uzima wa milele. So, every one of us has something to offer, something to administer. Can we do it with all our heart, with our love, and serve well, so that people and God will appreciate our services? And as we bring back to the community what we have learned, where we have been, to be raised to this level, you must qualify to be promoted to the next class, isn't it? Mwalimu ataangalia umeiti. Umepita mtihani. So you know the qualifications to be raised to level 4. You must have 1, 2, 3, 4. I think there are about 6. I googled today. Na wataalamu na Google kitoko. And how many level 4, 5, 6? Hata mimi nimepitia. Nimeona. So on this side, we thank God that you have also been raised to level 5. And can you live to the standards of that level? And then also be promoted to the next. So we thank them. Let us give them a clap. One. I said one, but it's hard. One. So you must have worked hard. Thank you, the staff. All those who have put in their efforts to reach that level. So shukuruni Mungu. Yeye ni mwema kweli. Na muwe na bidii, endeleeni kuonyesha bidii kwa haya. Hata msipoangaliwa vizuri na watu, msipotazama vizuri kwa mshahara, angalieni yule aliye juu. Simuseme amen.
Amen.
Maase zwa nikasirika. So, discharge your services fast, isn't it? When you are doing it so well, God is not asleep. God will always provide. Yule Bwana atakujaza. Ajuaye aliyo serini. So, you have done very well. Continue doing good. And others will emulate you. They will also learn to improve their quality of service. So, I urge you and encourage you that continue working hard and continue serving. Because being like here on the highway, patients will come from all over, even from Uganda, to come here. I've seen patients come from Kakamega. As I was telling my colleagues here, I was one of the patients here. When it started, I was admitted here. 2012, so when I started, I don't want to tell you what I'm suffering from. Everybody is sick, isn't it? Kila mtu ni mgonjwa. Kianza kupimwa hapa, utasema wachia hapo yangu, wacha niishi tu nayo. Even the doctors are sick, isn't it? Even the more sick than us. Okay. Let us accept and move on. Even those who treat us, they are also patients. And that is an encouragement. Sometimes when the doctor judges with you and he tells you, accept this, when you see all these people coming, they are all sick. We are all sick. And you get encouraged. So, tunapofanya hii kazi, tuifanye kwa upendo, tuifanye kwa uvumilivu, kwamba tunamfanyia Mungu. Let it not just be a show and be ourselves. And God will reward you. The Father who sees you, what you are doing, will reward you. So finally, others who have come to this celebration in your small way or your big way, you also learn something. That when you go back, do something. Not for yourself, but for others. And your selfishness is a problem. Ubinafsi. mtu anaanza tu kujifanyia and in the end you are leaving those things. But a facility like this, huduma kama hii, uwepo usiwepo, lakini umetengeneza watu wa kuendelea na hii kazi. Umeimba hapa injili iende wapi? Na hii ndio injili. Usituangalie sisi hata hapa watu wajua hapa ndio wanatakana kuhubiri injili. You are also spreading that injili by your services. Ukifanya kazi hiyo vizuri kwa wagonjwa, kwa dini, kwa watu hao, you are spreading the good news. The good news. And God is happy. Even if nobody recognizes you, but that patient, kwenye hapo, anasema tu kama angekuwa huko. And you see how trust we put in you. Hata mtu akija kwa hospitali na trust, na huyo daktari anauliza yuko. Even a nurse, mwenye hata si daktari, anasema, anamuita tu daktari. Daktari Rosa hako. Kama ayuka anasema nitangoja akute kwanza. Because the trust they are giving you. Just the care, the smile and so on. Will give the patient some hope. To continue. Even if it is one day or two, you have added value. You have added life. That patient, not to us. So may God bless the work of your hands, and may God give more in this industry, invest more in the medical care. Are we together?
Yes.
Let us not invest more in the bus. Nilipo kuja mwingine akaniambia unaona hizo tukutuku. Akasema ndio. Hizo mpya mtu mwingine amestaafu, principal mwingine na amenunua tukutuku sita. Tukutuku. Ama tukutuku. Can you retire? Sasa nikasema na huyu principal tu mzima si angeweka hizi zote pamoja anunue pick up. So suombe hekima ya Mungu ikusaidie. What do you plan? You see how these things are becoming scraps in a few months. Where is your treasure? Where are you investing? If this family can invest in medical care. Now we are even sitting here in a hotel. I don't know if we are also opening it or blessing it, but we want to come back again that time for the hotel. So these are services. May more people invest for wagonjwa. I work in the mountain. There you say, thank God. God knows how those people survive. Because you need a punda to bring you to Jeptai. And you reach Jeptai. If there is an ambulance, if you are so serious to bring you to town for this hour. But now they are here. We were going to Eldoret. But thank God you can stop here. So let us be ambassadors to take the messages. Ukiwa hata na kahospitali kako kadogo, usifunge. Kanapeana huu?
Huduma kwa
watu. Don't compare yourself. That sasa mimi nataka niwe kama Jacob.
Hapana.
Go by your shoe. If you are number 6, wa mama. Baa tu kiatu namba 5. Usiende namba 10. Anzia tu hapo. So vitu vina grow. So if we have these facilities here, whatever, let us use them well. Let us inform our people. The county hospitals, the sub-counties, we pray that they also acquire these facilities. Those who have, say thank you. But when you spread them in such places in the county, people will be healed. People will not die on the road. We ministers of burial, we are burying. You treat, but we bury. Do you know that? For our burials also. So, some people never reach the facility. If you that this facility could be around or could be near them, they could be all right. So I'm challenging those. You must have those people who are mentioned in level 5, and you have been introducing them, the neurosurgeon, the what. I've seen the names. Some I see them in the morning, referral. I'll see them here. Please discharge those duties and love. With love. And if I say my kid to Jakwaza, who do my kwaza? Kino siangalia mugonjo na usena amelipa. Sasa mimi mtatoa watu, Jako. Nikifika waniudumia kwanza ndio uulize malipo. So, and these people repay for me. Simultane repay.
Yes.
That is good. Najua wenye watalipa wako hapa. Wengine hawatalipia. Kini, put the patient first. I know the economy is bad, but treat with love and care. They will go back and try and do something. I know those are the challenges. You need the medicine, you need the what. But let us encourage our people to come and feel hospital in this facility. So may God, who started this good work in you, continue. And may others also learn to bring these services home. Something could be better. Isn't it? Sometimes we are having facilities, but there are no drugs. Singine hata wanafanya Monday to Friday, weekend wamefunga. Kwenye niko na taabu hiki. I have been a priest, I have been in the ambulance, I have been a doctor. At night, mimi ndio naamka. Saa zingine naenda nalalia Lukulu hospital. Napeleka mgonjwa Lukulu. Naamshwa usiku, kufika huko ni asubuhi. Na kurudi huko watu wanangojea misa. So I become an ambulance. Na nimebeba watu. Ukifikisha huko nauliza, mna mafuta ya kuniwekea kwa gari na huko wananiambia, Father, Holy Ghost. Tuko tu hivyo, hile walitoka kwa nyumbi. Tena mbefia na kimpia ununue, gloves ununue ABCD. Anasema Father, sinisaidia ununue gloves. Asa mimi pia naanza huku, masikuizi kwa gari yangu na iweka gloves. Wengine huo anajifungulia kwa gari yangu. My car has become a maternity ward. So we work in difficult places. Sometimes when I go to the health meetings and I give statistics, wananiuliza na hizi fadha unapata nawaambia mnafikiria kazi yetu ni kuhubiri tu neno. Lazima tuangalie kwa jumuiya, tuna wagonjwa. Nikitembea nyumba kwa nyumba making records. So that when I get to the health meeting, I'm also hot. Naambia that officer, that area has a lot of measles, marasmus, and other things. This facility, get out. Anasema father ni mkali. Si Yesu alikuja wapone. Na watapona kupitia kwako, nikukwambia nenda huko. When I was in the boat, and I was here, commander were in those islands, I go to the hospital first, get the drugs, the ones I can administer, not those expensive ones. Nipatie panato, nipatie, kwa sababu nikuwa namaliza huko wiki. Sasa nikienda wamengoja tu daktari na kabla nianze misa natibu watu, najifanya hata napangusa vidonda, naweka hii na hii. Na walikuwa wanapona kwa imani. Nilikuwa daktari wao. So there are things we need to collaborate. Collaborate. Let us collaborate and serve our people better. And the places we need. As I've told you, some places I pass, the hospital was closed on Friday. The nurses and that clinical officer will come on a Monday at 9. But I have a report to make. Those of you who are working in the government county hospitals, I have a very serious on some of these dispensaries and health centers where I work, when they are closed and when they open. So with those many or a few remarks, may God bless the work of your hands, instilling that love and good services in you so that our people, our country, live a healthy and productive life. God is good.
All the time.
Thank you very much for listening. You clap for me. If I... Kama ni mwanasiasa mnapiga makofi, lakini kama ni father mnasema malize tuende. That have enabled us to be where we are. Bless each one of us. Bless the work of our hands, that we may continue serving you and loving you in our brothers and sisters. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Kwa uvumilivu, upendo, kwa kazi wanapotenda kazi yao, Baba tukuomba.
Tukuomba utusikie.
Sala kwa ajili ya familia, Mungu Mwenyezi, milele. Upendo kubariki familia zetu. Uziwezeshe kuishi kwa upendo, amani na umoja, na kuiga familia takatifu ya Yesu, Maria na Yosefu. Tukuomba utusikie.
Tukuomba utusikie.
Tuombe huduma mbalimbali kati yetu. Mungu Baba, Mwana na Roho Mtakatifu, tunakushukuru kwa huduma mbalimbali ambazo umetupa kati yetu, ili tuweze kusifanya kwa upendo, kwa uaminifu, ili siku moja huduma hizi siweze kutusaidia kuona uso wako. E Bwana, tukuomba.
Tukuomba utusikie.
Salamu Maria.
Umejaa neema. Bwana yu nawe. Umebarikiwa kuliko wanawake wote. Yesu mzao wa tumbo lako amebarikiwa. Maria mtakatifu, mama wa Mungu, utuombee sisi wakosefu.
Hivi tunavyo kutolea unawatia nguvu wanadamu wote kwa chakula na kuwafanya wapya kwa sakramenti. Tunakuomba utujalie tusisindikiwe riziki hizo za kimwili na kiroho kwa njia ya Kristo Bwana wetu.
Amina.
Bwana awe nanyi.
Na awe rohoni mwako.
Inueni mioyo.
Tumeinua kwa Bwana.
Shukuru Bwana Mungu wetu.
Ni vema na haki.
Kweli ni vema na haki, tendo la kufaa na kuleta wokovu. Tukushukuru wewe daima na popote, e Bwana Baba uliye mtakatifu, Mungu mwenyezi wa milele. Wewe una haja na sifa yetu, lakini sifa hii ni kipaji chako tunachokurudishia kwa shukurani. Maana nyimbo zetu na sifa hazikusidishii kitu, bali zatufaa sisi kupata wokovu kwa njia ya Kristo Bwana wetu. Kwa hiyo pamoja na malaika wa mbinguni tunakusifu tukiungama kwa furaha. Kila kiumbe kilichoumbwa nawe kinakusifu kwa haki, maana kwa njia ya Bwana wetu Yesu Kristo na kwa uwezo tendaji wa Roho Mtakatifu unavitia uzima vitu vyote na kuvitakatifuza, wala uwaji kukusanya watu kwako ili toka mawio ya jua hata machweo yake dhabihu safi itolewe kwa jina lako. Basi e Bwana, tunakusihi kwa unyenyekevu vipaji hivi ambavyo tunakutolea ili uvitakaze. Upende kuvitakatifuza kwa roho huyo huyo ili viwe mwili na damu ya mwanao Bwana wetu Yesu Kristo aliyetuamuru tuadhimishe mafumbo haya. Maana yeye mwenyewe usiku ule alipotolewa alitoa mkate na akakushukuru, akaubariki, akaumega na akawapa wafuasi wake akisema, twaeni mule nyote, huu ndio mwili wangu utakaotolewa kwa ajili yenu. Vivyo hivyo baada ya kula, akitwaa kikombe na kushukuru, alikibariki na akawapa wafuasi wake akisema, twaeni munywe nyote, hiki ndicho kikombe cha damu yangu, damu ya agano jipya na la milele, itakayomwagiwa kwa ajili yenu na kwa ajili ya wengi kwa maondoleo ya dhambi. Fanyeni hivi kwa ukumbusho wangu. Bwana tunatanga adhimisha ukumbusho wa mateso ya mwanao yaletayo wokovu pamoja na ufufuko wake wa ajabu na kupaa kwake mbinguni, na tunapotazamia ujio wake wa pili, tunakutolea kwa shukurani sadaka hii iliyo hai na takatifu. Tunakuomba uyaangalie matoleo ya kanisa la kufara ambaye ulitaka kutulizwa kwa sadaka ya kifo chake. Tujalie sisi tunaotiwa nguvu kwa mwili na damu ya mwanao na kujaswa roho wake mtakatifu, tupate kuwa mwili mmoja na roho moja katika Kristo.
Yeye atufanye sisi tuwe kwako sadaka timilifu ya milele, ili tuweze kupata urithi pamoja na wateule wako. Kwanza kabisa pamoja na Bikira Maria mwenye heri, mama wa Mungu, na mtakatifu Yosefu, mume wake huyo bikira, na mitume wako wenye heri, na mashahidi wako watukufu, na watakatifu wote ambao tunategemea kupata daima msaada wa maombezi yao mbele zako.
Tunakuomba Bwana, huyu aliye kafara na upatanisho wetu, alete amani na wokovu duniani kote. Upende kuliimarisha katika imani na mapendo kanisa lako linalosafiri hapa duniani pamoja na mtumishi wako Baba Mtakatifu wetu Francisco na askofu wetu Mark Kadima pamoja na maaskofu wote, waklero wote na watu wote unaowafanya kuwa taifa lako.
Sikilize kwa wema sala za jamaa hii ulioita hapa mbele yako. Baba uliye mtakatifu, kwa huruma yako wakusanye kwako wanao wote waliotawanyika popote duniani. Wapokee kwa wema katika ufalme wako ndugu zetu marehemu na wote waliaga dunia wakiwa wamekupendeza. Nasi tunatumaini kufika katika ufalme huo ili pamoja tushibishwe milele kwa utukufu wako. Kwa njia ya Kristo Bwana wetu, ambaye kwa njia yake unaujalia ulimwengu mema yote.
Yake pamoja naye na ndani yake, wewe Mungu Baba Mwenyezi, katika umoja wa Roho Mtakatifu, unapata heshima yote na utukufu milele na milele.
La mwokozi wetu na tukifuata mafundisho yake ya kimungu, tunadhubutu kusema: Baba yetu uliye mbinguni,
jina lako litukuzwe, ufalme wako ufike, utakalo lifanyike duniani kama mbinguni, utupe leo mkate wetu wa kila siku, utusamehe makosa yetu
Bwana tunakuomba utuopoe katika maovu yote. Tujalie kwa wema amani maishani mwetu. Kuzudi kwa msaada wa huruma yako. Tuopolewe daima na dhambi. Wala tusifadhaishwe na jambo lolote. Tunapotazamia tumaini lenye heri na ujio wa mwokozi wetu Yesu Kristo.
Kwa kuwa ufalme ni wako na nguvu na utukufu hata milele.
Ee Bwana Yesu Kristo, uliyeambia mitume wako, amani na waachieni, amani yangu na wapa. Usitazame dhambi zetu ila tu imani ya kanisa lako. Ulijalia amani na umoja kama yalivyo mapenzi yako. Unaishi na kutawala milele na milele.
Amina.
Amani ya Bwana iwe daima nanyi.
Na iwe rohoni mwako.
Mpeane amani. Tazama mwana kondoo wa Mungu, tazama aondoaye dhambi za ulimwengu. Heri yao walioalikwa kwenye karamu ya mwana kondoo.
Bwana, sistahili uingie kwangu, lakini sema neno tu na roho yangu itapona.
Mwili na damu ya Kristo vitulinde tupate uzima wa milele.
Amina.
Sana kabla ya kumunyo, sana ya imani.
Yesu Kristo mwokozi wangu, nasadiki uko kweli katika hatari hapa. Nasadiki kwamba nitapewa sasa hivi mwili wako na damu yako, pamoja na roho yako na umungu wako. Nasadiki kwani ndiwe mwenyewe uliyetueleza. Amina.
Sala ya matumaini.
Mungu wangu, umesema kwamba watu wa
Tafadhali tusimame.
Tuombe. Yoyote mfanyayo kwa maneno au matendo yafanyeni kwa jina la Bwana Yesu, mkimshukuru Mungu Baba kwa kupitia yeye. E Bwana, sisi tulioshirikishwa katika meza ya umoja na mapendo, tunakuomba huruma yako ili kwa njia ya kazi ulizo tukabidhi tusifanye, tujalie tupate riziki kwa maisha yetu hapa duniani na kujenga ufalme wako kwa matumaini, kwa njia ya Kristo Bwana wetu.
Amina.
Mama, 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 mama,
kwaya kaza mwisho. Tukishamaliza baraka, tunaomba mturuhusu sisi mapadri tunaenda kuhudumia wagonjwa wengine. Si nyinyi tumewahudumia? Si nyinyi wagonjwa tumemalizana nanyi? Mturuhusu tuende chwa kwa baraka. Bwana awabarikie na kuwalinda.
Amina.
Awaangazie nuru za uso wake na kuwafadhili.
Amina.
Awainulie uso wake na kuwapa amani.
Amina.
Na baraka yake Mungu Mwenyezi ya Baba, Mwana na Roho Mtakatifu iwashukie na kukaa nanyi daima na milele.
Amina.
Endeni na amani kumpenda na kumtumikia Bwana na kuhudumia ndugu na dada zetu. Misa imekwisha.
Tumshukuru Mungu.
Asanteni, muwe na siku njema.
Second is evidence-based medical practices. Durban has seen in many ways heavily invest in infrastructures. As some of you have visited the facility, you have seen the hospital has actually invested a lot in the infrastructures. I think it's one of the best facilities around this region in terms of infrastructure. And thirdly, in formulating our policies, we are guided by a patient-centric approach, where the patient-centered service is our main agenda in providing services. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Mayor. As you heard, my name is Dale Simil. I'm the operations manager. But since the inception of this process, I've been the quality manager. And I've been the key driver of the process. And people who I've been with, including our lab team, no ISO is not that easy journey. We got our motivation from our lab team. As you can see, we have some engineers. We have a standalone banner there showing our lab is ISO 15189-2012 accredited. So most of us were asking, what is this ISO and what are these standards? At the time I visited Nimrod and he told me ISO 15189 only applies to the lab, not the facility. Then we went into research and asked what is ISO 9001-2015, just the same way some of you are asking. So the journey began in 2020. amongst ourselves. I remember our first trip, we went to Eldoret Hospital. I want to thank the team from Eldoret who are here for a benchmarking exercise. And everything we were being told was vocabulary to us. Then I, with the team of Oscar, who is the deputy quality manager, were wondering how we're going to do this thing. But we want to thank God, we want to thank the support of our directors who are here, who supported us, motivated us, and encouraged us to this journey of 2015. We are happy. This day, we remember our first audit, the regional coordinator of Kenya Bureau of Statistics, who is here today, who will present the certificate to us. This came as an auditor who didn't even know we are hosting such a powerful person. But we thank God, Kenya Bureau, we thank you very, very much, Mr. Mitchell. Thank you. This is your home. Karibu, karibu sana. I want also to thank people who stood with us throughout this journey, including he's been supporting me as a audit manager from point A up to this point where we are seated.
Thank you very much. Now, Dr. Kis.
Just three things that we keep in mind. Number one is our patient. Patient is the first person, first item on our agenda. Number two, quality. And number three is satisfaction. Once you have a patient who is being taken care of in a quality way, there will be satisfaction. This is what has enabled us to become a level 4 facility, where we have up to our 100-bed capacity hospital, up to 4 ICU beds capacity, modern renal unit, modern state-of-the-art theaters. So, any of you can feel welcome at our facility, just pop in. If you need to have a small headache, just pop in a small flu.
Thank you very much. Please appreciate Dr. Can you shed some light about your area of specialization? Sister Cynthia.
Guiding our doctors in the method of treatment.
Our accreditation journey started in the year 2017 as a laboratory. We worked all through this journey through participation of external quality assurances like Ketone Consulting, Focus, and many other external providers. It's this that has worked and made us be accredited as a laboratory to this point. Most importantly, as Dev has mentioned, we played as test setters for this very important day that we are here today. We challenged the entire facility to do whatever they did to take us to this point and to make this day for us. So the laboratory has really played a very key role in the area of quality and the area of providing quality services in the facility.
Thank you, sir. The very beginning of the assumption.
So we are able to take this one. the one who said that if you don't take care of your customer, someone else will. So for us, our priority is you, our customer, and we commit ourselves to serve you better, your quality of care, and you have with us. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Let me invite them to come here for our photo session. Let us give them a round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the cabinet that takes this ISO certification. Let us put our hands together for these wonderful people. Let us give them a song in order to have the one and
I'd like to say, I'd like to speak to the making.
desire to do the best for the world. And so, as consultants, there's one thing that we admire. I am a consultant in the department from one of the hospital, I'm from the referral facility, in Moi Teaching and Referral facility. And one of the things that we actually they picked up was the medical services. We are just part of the new consultants that working in this place. And I can say that this strategic partnership has significantly reduced the referrals to our national facility. And in turn, has attracted a lot of super specialties who are working in this place. And therefore, ensuring that our patients are getting the best at their doorstep. And this is what we have met, and this is what we have tested. We need to have that private partnership that makes a significant increase to our facility as well as coverage. So for me, it is a great honor to be in this place. And I enjoy so much as a consultant in this place because everything that I need, I'm provided. And so when I was asked, when the first one was coming here, I was sure that I was supported because some of our research things are very expensive. And the CEO said the lecture shall be done. And after within 2 weeks, everything that was there. So we are dealing with a facility that is a gem, and clearly we need all of us to support it. And the sky is the limit for this place.
Thank you, consultant.
Today, we are very happy to come here to celebrate the Kandoma Whisper Hospital getting the ISO. For me comes the Bangoma several times. We are staying in this hotel, see the hospital, it's a nice hospital, nice hotel. We are like it. Also, we like the Bangoma. Yes.
Thank you.
We always encourage our people, particularly young ones, that if you go to school, study so that no one questions your purpose. And that if you are given a job or a work to do, do it to a level where I have worked to this hospital for many years, and I'm happy that the people who have served with commitment have been paraded here as having risen to the positions they hold. It takes sacrifice and commitment that you will also rise to be here. Dave, as you aspire to work better to serve people and even others, look forward to growing beyond this hospital and allow others also move. I appreciate doctors, nurses, and everyone, because when I joined Form 1, I had a dream to become a medic. But somewhere down the line, by Form 3, I had become a clinical officer. At Form 4, I don't know what happened. I became a teacher. But I must register my appreciation that from the day I was circumcised, no other human being has ever seen me naked apart from my wife and the dicks.
Congratulations. It takes a lot of energy and sacrifice to arrive at where you have arrived. And like I was imagining, getting fat is never an issue. Maintaining the fatness is the issue. Is it true that getting where you are may not be an issue, but maintaining yourself at where you are for people to keep praising you may not be very easy? But we want to pray for you. We have come a long way as a teaching fraternity since this initiation of this hospital. Remember when the insurance companies, particularly those offering insurances to teachers, were tossing you left, right, and down? We stood by you. We shall keep on standing by you until and when you give us the best. The highest clientele you have in your facility are teachers. Initially, we'll make calls to demand this and that has not been done. And always you listen to us and make changes. Today as we speak, we can take more than 3 months before we make any call for any reference or consultation to the doctor. Congratulations, and because we are here to celebrate and join you in your achievement, we are overjoyed. We have nothing more. Politically, we want to urge everybody in this country and county. We have political differences, different urges for other people to get seats. Denson has had to play his card for his person. Somebody else will play a card for the different person. What we urge is peace and peace. This country will remain ours. This country will remain ours. People will go. Dr. Wanyama will die. This facility, Bungoma West, will remain if it's guarded. So let's guard Kenya, let's guard Bungoma County, and for those of you seeking positions, remember we are others also seeking for those positions. Mosikatalie Pale, God be with us.
My name is Paul Masika. I'm the principal of a tiny school called Chebukwa Secondary. Denson has made some noise here. At one time, the doctor had a letter to go to Kibabi, but he didn't find somebody to sponsor him to Kibabi because there was no scholarship. So I sponsored him at Chebukwa Secondary School. So that is where the doctor went to school. It was a small place. Recently, we wanted to pull down your laboratory, the laboratory used doctor, but we said we shall preserve it as a museum in the honor of Dr. Chebukwa is now coming up. If you come there, you will see state-of-the-art facilities, most of which have been put up courtesy of Dr. Wanyama. As you pass on your way to community, please, you are welcome to Chebukwa to just see the face, the new face of Chebukwa, courtesy of Dr. Wanyama. And we have seen ISO certification, which we are celebrating. We want to congratulate you. And we also want to be mentored by you. And in the near future, we want our school to also go the ISO certification style. Thank you, and God bless us all. But then before I forget, I came with my teacher, Madam Claire, is a very important person. She's a representative of CUPET. I wish you could give her a chance. If you don't give her, they may vote me out. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Let me just give you 30 seconds to just say congratulations. Kindly. Thank you.
In this function, and the fraternity of Bungoma West, I say good afternoon. I say, Dalia, I'm Wanjala Claire, a teacher at Yehupa Secondary School. And I taught Mr. Wanyama biology, and that's why he's what he is. I may look young, but I'm not young. And he can ascertain that he was a good boy. And on that note, he was somebody of quality, and that's why everything that he does is of quality. I'm a client in his hospital, and I've received good medication. And on behalf of Bungoma teachers, I said I'm the General Secretary of CUPET, Bungoma County. We really appreciate the effort that he has put in his hospital. And kindly please call other members and other groups to support Bungoma West. Be blessed.
Thank you. Thank you. I was scanning around to see whether I should speak in English or in Swahili. But I think because I can see we are combined, tumechaganyikana na akina baba zetu, akina mama zetu, itatumia zote mbili, lugha zote mbili ili tuelewane. Because I can see also we are people who may not even understand this language. Kwa majina naitwa Samuel Kimiti, mimi ni County Commissioner. Nataka kushukuru nafasi hii, kwanza kushukuru Mungu kwa sababu ya kutupatia nafasi hii ambayo tuko naye siku ya leo. Ya pili ni kupongeza daktari kwa sababu ya kupata hii certificate, ISO certification. Ni kazi kubwa kupata hii certificate. I know you must have worked very hard to get it. Number three, nataka kukaribisha, in as much as I've been invited here as a guest, niko nyumbani. I also want to welcome all the guests who have been invited here by Dr. Wanyama, because I know he has invited many people from outside this county. So wale ambao umetoka bali, na karibu, karibu Bungoma. I want to take a very short time. Because I also want to request you, Bwana Wanyama, Dr. Wanyama, I would have liked to stay up to the end of the program, but I also have a lot of other jobs which are waiting for me to do, and therefore I would like to be that he allows me to speak so that I can excuse myself. As I stand here, I'm a testimony of the certificate you have been given. Hii certificate, Dr. Wanyama amepata, CEO ya Badia. This certification, he has got it genuinely. Why do I say this? I want to start by saying, I have benefited from the services of his hospital, and not only myself, or even my spouse. Kwa hivyo, I have every reason to come and celebrate with him and stand before you and see what he has been genuine services. And what does that mean to other people who are doing these services, who are giving health services to the people? It means that for you to get this certification, you must serve your people or your client genuinely. Wale ambao wanapatiana huduma hii ya afya mzuri, tuhakikishe kama uko kwa serikali, kama uko kwa private, mzuri ujue binadamu na na binadamu ni mtu wa dhamana sana na kwa hivyo anataka huduma ya hali ya juu. You can't treat a human being like the way you would treat a cow or another animal, because a human being, even when God created human beings, he created us second to him, and then the rest of the animal or creation came after. And therefore, that value that has been given to human being, we need also to give those services, health services of that nature. Number two, I want to thank you, Bwana Wanyama. What you are doing, in as much as it is a private hospital, you are also a partner in the government, because health services is a domain which is provided by the government to start with, but we also welcome other private partners to come and complement what the government is doing. Kwa hivyo ile huduma unapatiana katika hii hospitali, hata ikiwa ni ya kibinafsi, ni huduma ambao unashirikiana na serikali kutibu watu wetu, kwa sababu nchi inataka watu ambao wako na afya ndio waweze kujenga taifa. So I want to thank you and other players in this field who are complementing the government to provide health services. And most important, I know you are also providing employment and stimulating the economy of this county.
I am very happy to be here today. As you've heard, my name is Vincent Cheruiyot. I'm the regional manager, KEBS, and our region covers up to Bungoma. And on my own behalf, on behalf of the office, the regional office, and also on behalf of our MD, who was not able to be here, I would wish to really congratulate the team for the effort they have done. And I believe there is a story which we have heard from them. Getting certification is a journey, it is a process, and I'm very happy that I was also part of that journey. In the journey of getting certification, there is almost like three or four steps before you are awarded the certificate. So the first step usually is an initial assessment, basically where the certification body and the client, who happens to be Bungoma West here, interact for the first time. So at that point, we look at the system that they have established, and we basically identify some areas of improvement, which are most, I'm very sure you're all aware about, especially the team. And then from there, the journey continues. I think we've been told what happened. After the final assessment, which is called a certification audit, at that point, whatever issues are raised, they have to be addressed to the satisfaction of the certification body, which in this case is KEBS. Otherwise, I would also wish to confirm that Bungoma West Hospital actually merited and qualified for ISO 9001 certification. And that's why we are here today. And I'm very grateful and I'm really encouraging that Tari and team to continue with that spirit, as it will really, really benefit your clients. ISO 9001 system is a customer-centered standard. And the moment you comply with its requirements, there is a very high possibility that your clients will be happy. Finally, maybe the MC will. I don't know who the chief guest here today is. I've had it mentioned many times. I don't know whether it's myself or whether we're still expecting a chief guest, because I had a speech here from our MD. I don't know whether I need to read it at this point. The MC. Can I go ahead? Okay, let me. That was prepared by our MD, Kenya Bureau of Standards, Lieutenant Colonel retired Bernard Njiraini, during the ISO 9001 certification award to Bungoma West Hospital on 14th. The board chair, CEO, members of staff, invited guests, thank you for this occasion during which Bungoma West is to be awarded the ISO 9001 2015 Quality Management System under the scope of provision of healthcare services. This follows certification audits carried out between 17th and 19th November 2021, where some 14 non-conformities were raised and which corrective action was done. We are proud of you, Bungoma West Hospital, for being the first, and I repeat, the first hospital in the Western region to be certified in ISO 9001. Congratulations, this is no mean feat. This certification puts you in the world map of quality because it guarantees excellence in service delivery. It also improves a quick turnaround of results and ensures decisions and critical ones are made in good time. Ladies and gentlemen, the KEP certification body also offers other services which you might be interested in. For example, ISO 27001 Information Security Management System, and also ISO 4001 Occupational Health and Safety Management. We also have our training body called NQI, which also offers training in various standards such as that. We are willing to partner with you so that you can enjoy these services. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, I urge you to ensure that you live up to the expectations of these certifications. And congratulations once again. Thank you and God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you very much for inviting me on stage. My name is Dr. Nilesh Agarwal. I represent Elder Hospital as well as Elder Hospital Pharmaceuticals. I'm the director there. It's really a joyful moment for me personally to see Dr. Wanyama and his hospital achieve ISO 9001 certificate. Congratulations. We achieved the ISO 9000 certificate, as you know, when you came to Benchmark quite some time ago. And you are quite amazed at our facilities, and you are maybe wondering whether you'd be able to achieve the level of healthcare that you provide now. And you have done it. As Elder Hospital, we've partnered together from humble beginnings, very humble beginnings, in fact. 10 years ago, more than 10 years ago, Dr. Wanyama used to come to me for small medicines, to set up a small facility. And here he is, grown to a level which we are so proud of you, Dr. Harry. We really are. And we are so happy to have partnered with you all through the journey. And we are together with you for the future as well. And there are a lot of speakers who are going to say a lot of things. I've come here with some of my team here, Maggie, who has been serving you very well from the very beginning. She's our principal sales executive. I have Titus as my marketing executive. So with the, I mean, it goes to show where there's a will, there's a way. And Terry and Madam Director, we are so proud of
you. As the last person is that the energy levels are low. Good afternoon. That's much better. Now, say hello to the person next to you and tell them that it's great to see them in this occasion. And please ask them their names. Usalimia yule ambaye umekaribia na umulize jina lake, si ndio? Thank you very much. I want to make a disclaimer. My name is Wangari Demesi, representing the Karen Hospital. I serve as the Chief Operating Officer, and I'm representing Dr. Betty Gikonyo, who is currently our chairman, and she's also our founding CEO. We bring their apologies, they're not able to make today, because as indigenous institutions, I think we have an opportunity to show the world that it is actually possible to make a difference, especially in matters healthcare. So receive their congratulatory messages, and also from our CEO, Mrs. Juliet Gikonyo Nyaga. We are also in the process of cascading our new strategy. We are calling it DKH 3.0. We retire the current one at the end of June, and then the new one starts 1st of July. So she's going around our branches and all the departments cascading the same. So I have the pleasure this afternoon to represent the institution, and I'd like to take a minute and introduce my team members. We have Mercy, the Chief Executive Officer, Bungoma West Hospital, Dr. Wanyama. The Director, Bungoma West Hospital, my sister, Delia Wasike. The Hospital Management Team of Dave Dennis, Dr. Kisika, Cynthia Nimrod, Daniel, Oscar and Ken, as well as Dr. Asike, the consultant, the staff of Bungoma West Hospital, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. We are extremely humbled by the friendship and invitation received to grace this occasion. It is a great honor to witness the receipt of the ISO 9000 2015 certification by Bungoma West Hospital family. It is the culmination of great effort and dedication, not only by the ISO core team led by Dave, but also a true testament of the management support from the CEO and Madam Director and the entire management team towards this quality journey. It gives me great pleasure to join the hospital family today on this achievement. And it means that as a hospital, we have put in place systems for providing quality healthcare services. I therefore wish to take this opportunity to congratulate the management and staff for their dedication in ensuring that the hospital attains this coveted status. An ISO 9000:2015 is a mark of quality focused on continuous improvement and not for continuous improvement. We would also like to congratulate you for the elevation to a level 5 hospital. Your hard work will be rewarded as you continue to offer excellent specialized healthcare services not only to the Bungoma community, but also to Kenyans at large. To our Bungoma hospital partners, always remember that ISO certification is not an exam and should not be revisited when internal and external audits are around the corner. It is a way of life and must be ingrained in the DNA of your hospital. Everything you do, especially when no one is watching, must speak of excellence. A lot of work went into the development of the proper documentation. They should not become part of the furniture, but must instead be a Bible that offers guidance on quality. Whenever you falter, don't worry. There are provisions on corrective actions taken in a bid to ensure continuous improvement. Ladies and gentlemen, The current hospital received the ISO 9000-2012 accreditation in 2010, barely 4 years after opening our doors to the public, and we then transitioned to ISO 9001-2015, the current standard. We therefore understand the hard work, unity of purpose, and teamwork that fuels this achievement. Additionally, our laboratory is ISO 15189-2012 certified for compliance with quality management systems and is committed to continuous improvement in service delivery, headed, of course, by Amos and his team that were part of that process. Please allow me to say a few words about the current hospital. We are a hospital healthcare system comprising of 9 branches countrywide. We have a foundation, which is the Heart to Heart Foundation, that mainly takes care of children who have heart conditions but are from underprivileged communities, and we are able to fund their treatment. Then we have the current Hospital Medical Training College, which consists of the nursing school plus other clinical training certifications that we have. The current hospital is a 102-bed multi-specialty hospital in Kenya, located in Karen along Karen Langata Road, with the state-of-the-art amenities, equipment, and well-trained staff committed to delivering the most effective and compassionate care to all our patients. We also offer expertise and treatment options conveniently located in different parts of Kenya across our 9 branches. Since our inception in 2006, the hospital has been acclaimed for excellence in clinical care in Africa and beyond. And that is why today we have come to celebrate with Bungoma West Hospital, being, as I said, an indigenous institution. And we know that this is the beginning of a great journey, and will be many others that we can come back to this place and celebrate. The current hospital has been the preferred healthcare provider not only in Kenya, but also we have ventured in the East and Central African region. We have been privileged to be able to offer our services in Uganda, Tanzania, Gambia, South Sudan, Morocco, Eritrea, Djibouti, Egypt, DRC, as far as the United Kingdom. We are actively engaging partners in the medical fraternity from these countries in line with our mission of providing specialized evidence-based healthcare services, including treatment, training, and referral for Africa and beyond. Quality, affordable, and accessible healthcare services are in great demand in our country. And as Kenyans, we are capable of delivering these services through strategic partnerships. And as we come together as the Karen Hospital and Bungoma West Hospital, our partnership is to ensure that we are able to provide specialized services to complement what Bungoma West Hospital is already offering. This is only the beginning, as we shall be exploring more areas of mutually beneficial partnerships for greater good of our Kenyan people. Our shared core values of integrity, teamwork, and excellence will carry us through any hurdles that we might face together. As you have heard, the Karen Hospital and Bungoma West Hospital have a lot of things in common which are important in our partnership journey, and more importantly, to serve our mutual client, the patient. We would like to once again congratulate our partners, Bungoma West Hospital, on the attainment of this momentous achievement, and we wish you the very best in the next phase of your growth as you enjoy the benefits of ISO 9000-2015 certification. We are proud with you, and we have no doubt that we'll be coming back again, as I say, to celebrate many more milestones as we work together as your partners. Thank you once again, and we wish you God's best, and God bless you. Asante sana.
All protocol observed. Good afternoon. God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good, and that is nature of
God. Indeed, God is good. That is why we are here today. So I want to start by making a dedication of this ISO certification. I dedicate this ISO certification to our parents. Our fathers are dead, but our mothers are present. Mama Rebecca Wanyama and Mama Selina Wasike. And to our late Reverend Father Wanyonyi. Father Wanyonyi was very key to our hospital. He is one of the patients that we stayed with for a long time, for more than a month. And he was part of us, he was part of the Bungomoist family, and he always wanted quality. Every time we were doing audits, when we go and check on him, he was asking, how did you perform? So I feel that we should, I should dedicate this ISO to those key people because of their love and blessings to us as Bungoma West and as a family. Today, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, today we celebrate a significant milestone in the history of Bungoma West Hospital. Our commitment to champion the values of integrity, accountability, and customers' trust in providing equitable, accessible, and quality health services for all Kenyans has led us to this inspiring journey. From our humble beginning, we now have reached new heights of Bungoma West official as Bungoma West Hospital officially sets the record as the first private hospital in Western Kenya to have its quality management system certified to ISO 9001:2015. Ladies and gentlemen, I therefore take pride in the people who have worked day and night to achieve this feat. We share an independent relationship of having an institutionalized quality management infrastructure that satisfies the requirements of international standards and recognition. Now more than ever, we have an integrated system that enhanced seamless networking of processes and systems that made us united in our journey. As you all know, the success of a single entity is the success of all, yet the opposite is also true. We have faced many challenges along the way, COVID-19 pandemic being the ultimate test of the resilience of our system and processes. Our response was swift, and we played a huge role in the awareness campaigns and even the administrations of vaccines. Our role in the ongoing fight against COVID-19 increased our level of preparedness against our future pandemics. In the event of such an unfortunate eventuality, we will be ready, whether in the form of planning, building technology readiness, leadership capacity, logistics, upgrading, enhancing good governance, or performing other activities. Ladies and gentlemen, we have been tested, and this has allowed us to have a smoother coordination of the Bungoma West personnel, customers, and other stakeholders. On 14 May 2020, Bungoma West Laboratory was accredited to 15189/2012 by KNAS, which is the accrediting body. ISO 15189 is the gold standard for accreditation of medical laboratories, covering both management and technical requirements needed for assessing the competence of personnel. Our lab has been assessed against international recognized standards aimed at providing the existence of quality systems. Its technical competence put to task and the personnel engaged on their ability to generate technically valid results, suitable information. Our laboratory follows the principle of laboratory-based principle and its increased competence in laboratory system by all stakeholders, that is patients and clinicians. The whole process has been possible through the leadership of management headed by our able Chief Executive Officer, Dr. Wanyama, who has allowed resources to facilitate the operation of the process. The Bungoma West Management System applies a process approach based on 8 principles that international experts agree should be the heart of operational excellence. And these principles include customer focus, leadership, engagement of people, process approach, improvement, evidence-based decision-making, relationship management. The process approach means having a step-by-step sequence of action. Say what it does by documenting day-to-day operation procedures and systems. Do what it says. Work in accordance with those procedures and systems. Prove it with a certification audit which confirms that records that the procedure and system meet the requirements of ISO 9001:2015 are open in accordance with the standard. Based on our customer experience, ISO 9001 will better equip our hospital to meet its needs and improve the customer focus route. This has fundamentally changed our hospital where, one, internal processes are streamlined, improving efficiency with containment and saving while improving accountability and traceability. Two, a recognized mark of quality has opened our hospital to a bigger opportunities and partnership both at home and abroad. Three, staff motivation is improved through a greater clarity and focus on the hospital objectives. Time and resources is spent on what really matters to the hospital. Four, patient focus inevitably has improved service delivery and referrals. And five, both internal process and customer service ultimately improves competence leading to increased capacity. The standard, however, is not a one-off exercise. Regular reviews keep quality at the forefront of the hospital with continuous improvement process to better meet customer needs. Ladies and gentlemen, I take this opportunity also to express my gratitude to Kenya Bureau of Standards through their guidance and advice that has made it possible to gather here today to celebrate with us. As I wind up, ladies and gentlemen, I sincerely want to express my gratitude to each and everyone who in one way or the other has involved in the success of this historic event. According to Ralph McKell, and I quote, "If we can reduce the cost and improve the quality of medical technology through advanced nanotechnology, we can more widely address the medical conditions that are prevalent and reduce the level of human suffering," end of quote. As you've heard from the speech, you see our journey was from a humble beginning. We started from a chemist level. Then we found there's a gap in the healthcare system. So we saw there is need for us to start a hospital. And that is how Bungoma West was born. Why do we different? We are different from other facilities in that from our mission, we always aimed at world-class excellency and compassionate and also to have, to show love to our loved ones. And from our operations, that has been our key drive in delivering our services. And all patients who have been treated in our facility can really testify to that, because our team has to go as per the vision, the mission and vision and core values of the hospital. And our staffs are committed to our service delivery. That is why we are here. In the journey of ISO, they were ready when there were audits. They were always ready, cooperating, and they have really made it easy for us, especially me being the quality manager, the quality director. They have really helped me to reach this far. And I must say, thank you so much for believing in me and making it possible for me to stand here and witness this certification through your hard work. And to my husband, Dr. Anyama. Who is the CEO? He has been my mentor, my motivator. He has always, when I am always like giving up, he's always pushing me. So he has been a drive behind this ISO certification. And I must say, when I was still in this journey of directorship, I was shy, I was not that. But from his toughness, he has really mentored me, and now I can stand here and talk to many people. And I must say thank you. And for the love that he has shown to us as our family and the family of Bungoma West. And to our clients, we want to thank you for believing in us, because you see, a hospital cannot operate without clients. So you believed in us, and now you see, we are also, we also want to give you good things. That is why our lab, we are trying to have standards that are equal to the world class. Now Bungoma West is not Bungoma West. Bungoma West is at world class. That is where we are now. So when you come to Bungoma West, be confident that you are getting the best that you can get anywhere else, even in US. Come confidently, and all the treatment that will be given will be the best. Even if you went where they say, in fact, you are getting the best treatment. And to our suppliers, we really appreciate that we, as Bungoma West, we have come up with a brand which other hospitals have not been able to have, just because of our suppliers who have believed in us, who have always brought to us new drugs on the market, and also new technology to us. And thank you so much for also believing us, for extending credit facilities to us, and for always being patient with us. Thank you so much. And to our banking institutions, we also want to appreciate you for financing us, because we could not do all these things if it could not be from your financing that you have always accorded to us. So thank you so much, and we feel proud to have you around here today. And you can't forget the church. The church, as you can see, the church has really played a key role in our operations. So thank you so much to the church for your blessings, for always being ready to come to us. And to our priests, we must say that thank you, that even if our mentor, that is Father Christopher Wanyonyi, and who was our spiritual father, despite the fact that he is now the late, but we are still not orphaned, but because they can find time and come and be with us. Thank you so much, and I want to say may the soul of Father Wanyonyi rest in peace. To the community and society, we must say that we appreciate from your ambassador, because it's the community that goes around and says Bungoma West is the best place, and you are like our ambassadors. So we want to say thank you so much, and we will continue giving back to the community. And we, as I stand here, I saw the chief officer of trade, and it has been really our dream as Bungoma West that we embark on this issue of infrastructure, education, and healthcare. Now healthcare we have done, and other things we also want to be doing. So I request that if they can find us a place, our people, our children, when they are on holiday, they have nowhere to go for studies. If they can help us find a place, give us a place where we can put a good library for our children, so that we reduce this issue of Kandui, young people doing other businesses that are not good, but they can find time to go and read. That will be good to Bungoma West as we give back to the society. Thank you all for your presence today, and may God bless Bungoma West Hospital. It's now my pleasure that therefore to invite the Chief Executive Officer to make his address.
Different departmental heads, please come on stage.
Of Garen Hospital, our invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I take this opportunity first to thank God for what he has done for us. I really appreciate the efforts which each one of you has made to come here today. Before I make my remarks, I want to appreciate each one of you. I want to appreciate my mother, our parents, our mothers, as you were told by Madam Director, my wife. My father died. My father-in-law also died. But I'm privileged that I have my mothers around. So I appreciate them very much. And I don't think I can continue keeping my speech if I have not recognized them. My mother never went to school. She cannot even sign. She cannot read anything. But she has made me the way I am. When you have people pray for you, most things always open up. Mwalimu Nganga, sometimes I remember when I was nursing Father Wanyonyi, Christopher. I really managed, that is one of the patients we have really, really managed with all our efforts. And then one time, we felt like we go with him in Eldoret Hospital. I called Dr. Nilesh, who is here today. And when we went to Eldoret Hospital, choir members, most of you are not there, but Dr. Nilesh, I really take this opportunity to appreciate you because we put your hospital at standstill. You are not able to do anything. All the directors were out to receive us. We admitted our patient in your HDU without any admission fee, without any process. We take that one with a lot of repute, and we appreciate you, and we pray that his soul will rest in eternal peace. Sometimes you cannot talk too much about Father Wanyonyi. When my wife says we dedicate this ISO certification to Father Wanyonyi, to our parents, my mother Sedna, my mother Rebecca, I almost shed a tear. Quality was his word. Quality. He told me, Nectar, you are going to Bungoma? Tomorrow come with Mwalimu Nganga. I called Mwalimu Nganga, I go with him. Only I was going to take his Mwalimu body. Sometimes you wonder how we have managed. I believe you are getting me. Where I come from, when I started practicing, Dr. Wasike, he's a neurosurgeon, he's a senior neurosurgeon in Moi Teaching and River Hospital. But I think I'm also older than him. Because when I was working in Moi Teaching and River Hospital, I think they carry you were practicing as well. But I worked there for a long time. And a time came when we said, we want to start a hospital here. And when we started, some people wonder, where do we get money to start? I know others will say, oh, you lectare, ameiba pesa mahali ya mefungua hospitali. Ndiyo? Sikuna wengine wasema hivyo? Ama hakuna? Wengine watasema, which church that this guy go to? We have very many stories to talk about people like us. I'm here today to tell you that the journey to success is our financial institutions. Can we clap for them? When Master of Ceremony, I know people are very hungry, but I also want to assure you we have enough food. So don't worry. Because it has to pass. I want to take this opportunity to invite the regional manager, Bank of Africa, come here, because when we started building Bungoma West Hospital, the team from KETS, I wasn't running a pharmacy, but when I started thinking of, as my wife said, we start up a hospital, we didn't have money. But I made a proposal and took it to Bank of Africa, and I think the first loan they gave me was $25 million without any security. So even you need to make proposals. Regional manager, Bank of Africa with your team.
Sharing why he's not able to join us for this very good occasion. So I'll not take much time. Probably just introduce Richard, because he's our branch manager here for Goma, and I'll go straight away to our head of business, Andrew Lamau.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ida. Thank you, Daktari. Once again, my name is Andrew Kamau, head of business banking at Bank of Africa. Protocol demands that I don't speak at this point in time, but since I've been calling, allow me to first of all congratulate Dr. Tari and Madam Director and see her for this milestone. It's a great milestone, and obviously has taken a lot of hard work, patience, commitment, and so much. You have been part of this journey. We have seen this hospital grow for as much as Dr. Tari says, and we are immensely proud to see the hospital achieve this milestone. Our MD was keen to come for this occasion, but he was involved in many matters that were very critical and therefore not able to come. And allow me to pass my sincere apologies on behalf of our Managing Director, Ronald Barambi, and our Deputy Managing Director, Clava Serumata. They passed their apologies. They really have wanted to be here to see what they started years back.
Thank you.
And more importantly, it's what this hospital is doing for the community. I believe that we all are aware of what they are doing to the community, and that is what is most important. We have something small and entirely.
Good. Thank you very much.
I'll bring what is on it. Bungoma West Hospital, congratulations on the successful ISO 9001 2015 certification. We celebrate this milestone and are proud to be associated with you. Bank of Africa PMC Group.
branch manager, KCB Bank, with your team. Tunaenda vizuri? Okay.
My name is Eric Siganga, I'm the branch manager. With me, I think the introduction is going to continue from there.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
My name is Valerie Ambia. I'm a Universal Banker KCB Bungoma branch.
Good afternoon. My name is Peter Lusa. I'm the Bank Assurance.
The lady here, she is actually the relationship manager for this institution from day one. I'm actually 1 year old, so the history lies with her. And she's been able to manage a relationship that I've never seen him in the bank. I only talked to him on phone. So I believe things are handled pretty well.
Yeah.
On the other side, I think I'm also a witness of this because I'm sure he has no idea I come here for medication. I'm sure. You know, in Kenyan society right now, you must know people. You must know somebody.
Yeah.
You want to jump the queue, you have to call me. You have to go to the police station, you have to know CPD. Everything's about knowing somebody. And when things don't work, you call that somebody. Me, I've been here so many times, I've never called him. Because the system is working. Every time I come here, for me, the staff have handled me pretty well. I've never had a reason to call him. So this is a testimony of what you're doing, and we appreciate you. For you to get this again, where I'm coming from, it's a big thing. You have to plan for it. You must work the plan. You have to have dedication. So I want to thank your staff for the work they've done. And this is a very good thing for us, because if I look at your payroll, the number of people you are employing, it's massive. You're actually an institution on your own. And that basically means anybody is able to do something. For us as a bank, we're committed to continue going that journey with you. I know COVID came and disrupted so many things for you and everybody here, ideally. So we also extend our love to anybody else who's affected. We should be there to carry on the journey with you, see how we can revive the economy which are not working. Or wherever you are, as a bank, we're committed to do that. And walk the journey that we walked with you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Oh, we have to take our photo for our manager.
Hard work. I always see resilience,
to you. I see aggressiveness. And most important, always putting God first. I can attest to that. Daktari continues to exhibit those characteristics. So even as we stand here today, what we are witnessing, and from Dr. Wanyama that I know, this is just the beginning. We are yet, we will see more. As a man, as a friend, we will hold hands for each of these things. So congratulations for this day. So let me allow brother and before I call, maybe we'll just introduce my colleagues here. My name is Steve Kwasiche, the branch manager of Sabah.
Good afternoon, guests.
Good afternoon.
Absa Bank, we and Western Cluster, and we are here extremely excited. We are very proud of you, Daktari. We are really excited about what you are doing and the milestone that you are achieving today, which we are marking today in this celebration. And we have seen a lot that we learned from as an institution, as individuals, that you are one that believes in excellence. And we are always told excellence has no finishing line. But wherever you have achieved yesterday, tomorrow it becomes the bare minimum, and you have to continue extending so that you continue to be the very best. So we are really excited at the bank, on behalf of Absa Bank, the senior leadership who could not make it to be here. We are here to give you our congratulations for the achievements that you achieved. ISO 9001 2015 certification is a milestone, and we know it has taken a lot of hard work, commitment, dedication, teamwork, because the very disciplined staff that you have that have sacrificed so many hours to make it happen. We congratulate you, Daktari. Congratulations. We are very proud of you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, all protocols observed.
Good afternoon.
Tumsifu Yesu Kristo.
My name is Noah Sikuku. I'm the branch manager, NCBA Bank, Bungoma Branch. And on behalf of NCBA Bungoma Branch, I take this opportunity to congratulate Bungoma West Hospital for having been certified as ISO compliant. Dr. Anyama, we are proud of you. And as I am the nation, we look at Dr. Anyama, who is from you. Skatoro, where I don't know. Abugusu from Sikata?
Yes, Nangwe specifically.
Okay. Nangwe specifically for having established a hospital from the scratch and reached where it has reached. We are really proud of you, and we know you are serving the people of Ngoma. We know service to mankind is service to our maker. So we congratulate you, we are the new proof on the floor, and as NCBA, we always inspire greatness and we urge you to go higher and higher, and we shall walk the journey together with you. Together with me, I have my regional guys that I will give an opportunity to introduce themselves. Karim San.
Okay, my name is Ahan Kuyango. I'm from the regional office in Kisumu. I handle asset finance. Today we are here to congratulate Bungoma West for this great milestone. Congratulations, Daktari. Thank you so much. As a bank, we are committed to partner with you in many ways and to offer you great support. Allow me to give my regional manager to address the organization. Thank you.
All protocol observed.
All the time.
I just love the fact that when we came here and it was all God, and then we did God first, and then we did corporate second. To Dr. Wanyama and the whole Bungoma Hospital fraternity, our message to the from our GMB is ISO achievement is not a mean achievement. And for the Western region, and knowing that this is the only hospital in the Western region that is ISO certified, isn't it that great?
It is.
It is very great. So let's give them a round of applause. And we will support you. We want to walk this milestone with you, and we want to see this hospital going to level 7, if there is one level 7.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Let's be a bit quick to have the photo and the wait for the two more speakers. Thank you.
Yes, services in Bungoma West Hospital, you are able to access them elsewhere because the time of you people developing WhatsApp groups is now over. Now WhatsApp has started a formula where they just block you. If you want to put me on your group, you cannot be able. So the best for your health care is take insurance, pay 500 shillings a month for any child, and that will be your savior when you are sick. Your time.
For most hospital, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Dr. Sokano, I work for NGF Mugoma. Maranini was younger son of Manda Bukoma. So, my colleague will talk more about energy.
All the invited guests today, the choir, done very well today. I greet you all. My name is Daniel Tanui from Bungoma NHIF office. I'm the ICT in charge. And most of the time, we meet with the Daktari because he's a person who loves technology. And as the person who deal with the hospitals in Bungoma hand to hand most of the time, I normally face very little challenges with Bungoma West, mainly because their systems are to standard and very high quality. Very high quality. That one I've heard from some other guys who have talked here today, but I also confirm their internet, their machines, everything is very nice there. And I'm here today to congratulate the whole team for the good job they're doing. Apart from talking from the point of view from NHIF, I'm a client who have been there and I've been served well. Recently, I had a newborn, and my wife delivered there. And I was very happy because we were all in labor, including Tatai. So today, our manager was to be here, but he had another meeting with some guys from Nairobi, and he sent us here to congratulate this institution for the good service that they are giving to humanity in this county of Bungoma. I say thank you for the opportunity to speak here, and we say congratulations.
Thank you very much, Madam Tanui.
And again, sir, Colin Sapomo, I'm the regional location manager in Tijuana. Today, I have the colleague in me and just give him an opportunity to introduce himself.
All protocols of the side, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. My name is Kevin Makoka. I'm the care manager of Bungoma County. Maybe if I may allow to be to say something now. Before I came to Bungoma, I used to work in village in Homa Bay County. But I used to hear guys saying there's a facility called Bungoma West. Then luckily I was transferred to Bungoma and I came and saw the facility myself. This is what people have been saying. But there's a facility in Bungoma called Bungoma West. After staying in Bungoma for around 3 months, 4 months, I came to realize that what guys were saying was true. Because today in this building, if anyone can tell me a facility in Bungoma where you can find good drugs, I remember about a month ago, we were searching for a certain drug. Then came she. I called Dr. Tari and told him, I've shared with you a drug by WhatsApp. Kindly check if the drug is available. To my surprise, the drug was there. So, just to finalize, I would like to add the team to continue with the same spirit and to thank the doctor for the good relationship, because I remember we even usually call sometimes to say, there's a certain client, lakini mimi nimepita kidogo, wefanya hivi, tuache kama discount. So congratulations to you, doctor, and to the entire team for the good work. Thank you.
Hello everyone. Okay, my
name is
Naomi
Shekiri,
the manager
for
congratulations
from Bungoma West.
Thank you.
So, Natalie, received congratulations from our CEO, Dr. Mbui, Sam Mbui, and also our AGM, Mr. Ngoto. They really wanted to be part of this, though they had some other commitments, but they're saying congratulations. This facility, I think when we started LVNet specifically treating teachers, this was the first facility that we contacted in Bungoma, and since we had contacted the facility to provide the medical services to our teachers, they have never suspended. And also the feedback that I'm having from teachers all over especially in the Western region. Mr. Nanga can attest to it. I have this feedback. They are saying that this is one of the best facilities around the region. Not even one of the best, it's the best facility around the region. And it is also one of the facilities that is a referral facility. All these other hospitals in Kakamega, from Kakamega to Vihiga, Busia and Transoya, and also some parts of Washo Nations, they normally refer clients here at the time. These are very good work. And as I also resident of Bungoma, because I've grown in Bungoma, I've seen this hospital coming from a chemist, used to be around the Shalem Center there, as a chemist. And then when I went to studies, coming back, I saw Bungoma West here in Kanubi. I was very much proud. And it is a challenge also to all of us. Let us come home, let us invest home. And you see, most of these facilities, I have this, Dr. You give a lot of people hope and challenge. Because currently, most of these facilities that are providing medical services, they are Indians. They are coming from outside.
Yes.
They are coming from West here, and then they take those monies outside country. So, we encourage each and every one of you, let us invest in country. Let us go outside there. Let us, you see, the teachers has told us that the mother, she hasn't gone to school, but she made sure that Natalie went to school and she is where she is. So let us also make sure that our children are taken to school. That is the most important thing. And let us support them so that we can lift the Western people. Thank you so much, Natalie.
To the 3 p.m.
There are too many. Currently we have 136 suppliers who supply Bungoma West with pharmaceuticals and the non-pharmaceuticals. I know you may not talk, all of you, but I applaud you, I appreciate you very much. We have seen a lot of support from you, creating facilities, as Madame said, for seniors, that is dialysis. They are supplied us with the best dialysis machines. Dialysis is when your kidneys have failed because of diabetes. So the kidneys fail. We have the best machines called Fresenius. Dr. Yasike, Fresenius is only in Bungoma West Hospital and also in Moi Dichi and the hospital. Rota, am I cheating? Okay. I humbly take this opportunity to first and foremost welcome all of you to this historic event, which marks a milestone and great achievement in our hospital calendar. It is always a special occasion to celebrate such historic hospital events with distinguished people who mean a lot to the hospital's success. To all our visitors, hospital directorship, hospital management, staffs, esteemed clients, feel at home, and thank you for joining us today. Since our establishment, the hospital management has made major milestones in enhancing professionalism and offering of quality services to our stakeholders within our surroundings. to be a premier medical facility that is globally feasible in quality and affordable healthcare. We have invested heavily in knowledge generation and technological innovations which have greatly contributed to achievement of our mission and vision statement. Today, we are gathered here to celebrate the hospital's attainment of ISO 9001-2015 quality management systems, which indeed we have worked tirelessly to attain. I wish to take this opportunity to express my sincere gratitude to each and everyone who burned the midnight oil to ensure that this event becomes a success. To the ISO team, led by Director of Quality Assurance, Madam Delia, who is my wife, thank you for your efforts. Ladies and gentlemen, quality management systems entails all the development of management or a management system, which is dedicated to enabling the hospital to attain its set objectives. ISO 9001-2015 certification are central in enabling our hospital to meet its quality systems and improvement of our service delivery that will provide the foundation for better customer satisfaction, staff motivation, and continuous improvement. As a hospital, we have truly come to age since our establishment. Now, with this certification, we are putting our institution on the world map in terms of quality and excellence in provision of medical care programs and commit to all our clients' quality accepted standards of care within the international market. Ladies and gentlemen, what this means to us as an institution, it means now we know, now we stand the experience of continuous improvement in all our processes. Number two, it means improved financial returns and management. Three, identification of the hospital's stakeholders and understanding their needs and expectations. Number four, this means enhanced interaction between our clients and our staff. Number five, this ISO means continuous improvement and review of our policies. And this is where you need to continue doing it. And number six, motivation and commitment of the hospital's top leadership. Improved image of the hospital regionally and internationally. And lastly, this one means enhanced customer satisfaction levels. This level is an urge to every stakeholder of this institution to embrace the implementation of the new ISO 9001-2015 quality management system certification in order to ascertain that we all feel, experience, and enjoy the equipment benefits associated with it. I would also like to take this opportunity to candidly express my utmost gratitude to the Kenya Bureau of Standards, indeed through their guidance allowed us to attend the ISO 9001 2015, which has seen the hospital evaluate and improve on its quality management system development, management system documentation, review, pre and post audit assessment, and clearance of the non-conformities as identified. Lastly, ladies and gentlemen, I sincerely want to express my gratitude to each and everyone who in one way or another was involved in the success of this historic event. More so, I thank all of you for joining us in celebrating the feat that the hospital has achieved. There's a Chinese philosopher called Confucius. Confucius once said, "It does not matter how slowly you go, as long as you do not stop." Do you get what I'm saying?
Yes.
You are getting it?
Yes.
It does not matter how slowly you go, as long as you do not stop. Let me ask you today to never stop striving for excellence in your respective areas, as the past cannot be changed, but the future will strive for its yet in our power. My journey, the motivation. Why do I live? I live to inspire my society. I live to inspire my staff. I live to inspire my friends and all the people of goodwill. My wife, the director of this institution, I take this opportunity to appreciate you. You said I have been tough on you. But I think I'll double it. So that at the end of the day, we are able to succeed and people can emulate something from what we are doing. So let us work together always, and I know God will help us to achieve what everything we have dreamt of, we shall achieve. God and the church. I appreciate God for helping us in everything we have done. Sometimes people ask me and my wife, when do you sleep? Even the employees, they ask me, when do I sleep? Is that good manners already? It is hard work. You need to copy from us, so that even you, even you know what we are doing, and you succeed in what you do. The Church, Christ the King, you have been a great support to us. You have prayed for us. Since I started coming in Christ the King Cathedral, I've always seen you. Mama Presidis, my chair lady, she has always been close to us. The choir members, you are the greatest people we have. You are the best, and we appreciate you. Thank you all for your presence today, and may God bless the Bungoma West Hospital. All of you are.
Thank you. Certificate to Bungoma West Hospital.
Thank you very much. Thank you. To give you a coffee.
Thank you. I want to see you for a mission for all.
Makofi, makofi, makofi.